Greetings, this is Paul the Poke from paulthepoke.com. Today's topic, Yom Teruah, Feast of Trumpets, Rosh Hashanah declared. We are Tishri 1, 5, 7, 7, 9, or September 11, 2018 on our Western Gregorian calendar. Now it's official, the new moon has been sighted at 6:47 p.m. Jerusalem, Israel time. Rosh Hashanah declared. Well, maybe. So the following is stated by Brother Mark Harris of whenisthenewmoon.com. Some of you may be keeping this new moon as the seventh month based on the barley observation this year, and some may be keeping this as the sixth month based on the first new moon sighted after spring began. May you all continue to be blessed as you walk in obedience to the Creator and search out the truth in these matters. And hence the phrase of that day or hour, no one knows. Now, here is a photo credit courtesy of Kenny Russell. He is out there with those folks in the desert looking for the new moon. And the website is whenisthenewmoon.com. If you're interested in these sorts of matters, you can click on this website and get to the bottom of some of these issues as best as you possibly can. They also have a brief explanation of keeping time on God's calendar provided at their website, whenisthenewmoon.com. You can click on here to watch the video. It's, you know, a few minutes. Gives an explanation of how God had people keep time in ancient days. Now, these folks at whenisthenewmoon.com are located northeast of Jerusalem, and they follow the ancient practice of Rosh Kodesh, and that means head of the month. There are people who are trained witnesses to identify the new moon. When the moon goes dark, witnesses are looking for the tiny sliver to emerge. It's a tiny crescent that is noted briefly at sunset on the western horizon. This happens every month. God operates on a lunar calendar, and Jews have utilized the following procedure every month for thousands of years. And at the end of a lunar cycle, the moon is dark and is not seen for 2 to 3 days. The new moon can be identified during this 2 to 3 day period of that day or hour. No one knows. That's where the phrase comes from. The month begins at the sighting of the new moon. Two witnesses have to confirm the sighting. Upon agreement, the two witnesses report to the high priest. When the new moon is confirmed, the trumpet or the shofar, ram's horn, is blown. Humanity's timekeeping system is different than God's, and it's easy to see how these concepts of time are different and not on the same page. And I mean, there's even confusion with how God tells us to mark time. So neither one of these are perfect. And God marks time from month to month on a lunar calendar. The issue is not a mathematical calculation. I hear that frequently. Well, math, it's a mathematical calculation. This is when the month begins and blah, blah, blah. Well, identifying the new moon is a matter of truthfulness. Did you see it? Did you bear witness to it? And that's how God sees it. It's truthful verification as far as he's concerned. And so we get the idea of the two witnesses, Deuteronomy 19, verse 15, a single witness shall not rise up against a man on account of any iniquity or any sin which he has committed. On the evidence of two or three witnesses, a matter shall be confirmed. So that's it's a legal concept per the law in the Old Testament. Now, Tishri 1, Hebrew calendar, begins after sunset on Tuesday, September 11, 2018, Gregorian calendar, and continues until sunset the following day, Wednesday, September 12. Again, a day starts at sunset in a Hebraic mindset. With the establishment of new moon and month, the remainder of God's fall appointments can be proclaimed and dated, and they're converted on a Western Gregorian calendar. And you can look those days up. Now, secular Israel celebrates the new month of Tishri and calls it their new year, Rosh Hashanah. Israelis are celebrating the beginning of the year 5779. This is their civic calendar. Note, God calls Tishri the seventh month, Numbers 29, verse 1. Now in the seventh month, on the first day of the month, you shall have a holy convocation. You shall do no laborious work. It will be a day of blowing. It will be to you a day for blowing trumpets. You can also see this in Leviticus 23, verses 23 through 25. God's new year begins in the spring. Exodus 12, verses 1 and 2. Now the Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, this month shall be the beginning of months for you. It is to be the first month of the year to you. So even though this is technically the Jewish New Year, it's the seventh month according to God. The first month is in the spring. So if you're interested in these concepts, please feel free to check out paulthepoke.com. If you want to follow along, you can click on this blue bar and fill out your email address. You'll be alerted every time you get a new post, and you can follow along. Also, if you have specific categories you're interested in, feel free to scroll down here on the right side of the site, highlight any of these topics, and you can see articles written in regards to these specific topics going back 8 years now. So appreciate everybody following along. If you find it interesting, share it with others. Thanks a lot. Bye.